What up, though? Welcome to Rio's Reactions. Today, this is a powerful hip-hop song here. This is from The Roots. This is one of my favorite songs. The fucking beat is crazy. It's hypnotizing. It just puts you in a fucking trance, and that shit just literally take over your soul. I guess they call these niggas The Roots for a reason. This shit is fucking, this beat is crazy. So, without further ado, this is The Roots featuring my nigga Common. I think back when he was Common Sense, this is called Act Two, Love of My Life. The Roots from the Things Fall Apart album. Album cover's crazy. Typical Roots, though. Here we go. Motherfucking beat give me chills, dog. Woo! Shit. Black Thought was ripping that shit, too. He basically was just talking about, like, hip-hop is what got him out the ghetto. Like, it kept him, like, something to strive for. Like, that was his everything. Like, his passion. Like, all he did was focus on that shit. And that's what basically got him out of it. You know, that shit was, he broke that shit down ill. So, whew, that beat, oh.
The mic, hip hop, you the love of my life. So tell the people like that, y'all. And it sounds so, sound so. Hip hop, you the love of my life. We about to take it to the top of speaking. To my guy, Regan, I see what desperately seeking. To organize enough confusion, using no protection. Total resurrection. Caught in the Hype Williams and lost some direction. Eight in sections where I would eat her. Under the counter love, so solidly I treat her. Her daddy a beat her. Eyes off her. On tape, niggas had her in the buckle. Inside chip is more than just the fuck. The police and I found peace. Like Malcolm in the East. Seen her on the streets of New York. Tripping off, trying to make a hit with her. But my dick went soft. Moving weight, losing weight. Not picky with who she choose today. Too confused to hate. But I struggle out of late, close to 30. Most of the niggas she know is dirty. Having more babies than Lauren. She started showing early. As of late, I realized that this is a fate or destiny to bring the best to me. It's like God is testing me. In retrospect, I see she brought life.
Running all that back. Jesus Christ. Wow. Man, Common. Whoa. The way he just metaphorically, what he does with hip hop you know, as like a woman. You know what I'm saying? Like, that nigga just in love with hip hop. That nigga said, because of you, once I get into it with that nigga Ice Cube. Because of the whole, like, beef that was going on and shit like that, like, damn, he broke that. This could be a long one. That verse was crazy. I forgot about that shit. Oh, where we at on? It kept the hardcore for you. I remember late nights, steady rocking the mic. Hip hop, you love it. Here we go. So tell the people like that, show that it sounds so sound so good. Here you go. Love of my life. We got to take it down. I was speaking to my God. I see what death really seeking to organize and I'm confusing, using no protection, told on resurrection, caught in the hype, Williams. I told her on resurrection, caught up in a Hype Williams. Hype Williams was basically the bad boy fucking videographer. He was the nigga who was responsible for all those shiny suit type videos and shit like that. So basically what this nigga saying is like, you took hip hop into some bullshit. Like, cause a lot of people, that Puffy era was, that bad boy era was popular as a motherfucker. But like a lot of true like hip hop motherfuckers, them backpack type niggas, they wasn't feeling that shit. So that's just one. Getting eight in sections where I wouldn't eat her. Culture vultures. Now, before, hip hop was just for niggas. It was just for the ghetto. It was just for the youth. Now, it's everywhere. You got country hip hop. You got hip hop in every fucking name brand or brand name, popular commercial. Hip hop is like saturated as fuck now. You know what I'm saying? But back then, it was like just the lane. It was the rap lane. That was it, motherfucker. It wasn't even hip hop back then. So, another one. Kind of love, so solidly I treat her. Her daddy a beat her. Eyes off her. See what I'm saying? He talking about how Puffy basically abused hip-hop, took that shit commercial. Shiny suits and all that. You know, that's why Big wasn't fucking with that nigga at the end. He was done with that gimmicky-ass bullshit. That nigga said something about an abusive relationship, eyes all Puff. Damn. This motherfucker, man. This is gonna be a long one. So solidly I treat her. Her daddy a beat her. Eyes all Puff. Her daddy a beater, eyes all puffed. Retrospect, I see she brought life or death to me. Whoa. Did this shit come out after Big died? So he was dissing the shit out of Bad Boy in the beginning, and now looking back on it retrospectively, you brought life or death to me. The name of Big's second album, right? Or was that life after? Whatever. Damn. Let's bring that back a little bit. It's like God is testing me. In retrospect, I see she brought life and death to me. Peace to us collectively. Live and direct when we perform. It's just coffee shop chicks and white dudes. Over her, I got into it with that nigga Ice Cube. Peace. Not a fight, move to in life, making the right moves. Yeah. Besides God and family, you my life's true. Like that, like that, like that. Hip hop, hip hop. It's gonna be a minute and 50 seconds of the beat. That shit is crazy. It's worth every fucking second of it. Justice. Fucking beat right there. Common sense. That nigga nice as fuck, man. This nigga be doing like the Verizon commercial or some shit like that now? I know who the fuck he is, I'm just saying, like, damn, that nigga was spitting that shit. I don't know. I might redo this one. That was too long. I was in shock by the lyrics. That nigga was going that puff right there. Holy shit. Niggas be fronting on puff.